What would you do if I wanted to start an OnlyFans?
I don't think there's anything intrinsically wrong with women doing OnlyFans, as long as I had influence and control over it.
What do you mean? Doing a bit of photographer and get the angles, yeah?
No. I'm not doing any real work, but just like taking all the money.
Huh?
If my chick said, I want to do OnlyFans, I'm like, all right, then cool, go do it. How much you made? 10 grand, all right, give me 8. All right, cool.
Why would... What?
$20 vide, Andrew Tate, Mr. Misogynist himself. Well, no, actually, not really. The top G, innit? What we're going to do is watch some of his most offensive moments and see if we agree if he's a misogynist, if he's a piece of shit that people say he is, or if he really is the top G. Let's go.
Peter, you're cheating. It's bang out the machete, boom in her face, you rip her up by the neck.
Bro, chill. This is how we're starting the video.
Bro, truthfully, fam, you know what Future said? He said, if she catch me cheating, I would never tell her sorry. No cap.
Why would you suck dick for free?
Because I love doing it. What the fuck? I love sucking dick. Why would I?
You have no future with these men, so why not at least get paid for it,
right? I don't need to pay for it on fucking OnlyFans. I don't need them to pay me.
For $12, by the way.
They could ever give me.
Then get paid twice.
Oh, shit! Bro! You should get paid twice. Bro, this is why I like Andrew Tate. I know some of this stuff's a bit offensive, but like, bro, like, 2022, bro, we're so censored. And then this guy's out here, bro. Oh my.
Don't message me about depression because I don't believe in it. If you're asleep in your bed in the middle of the night and you hear a noise and you believe in ghosts, now you're afraid. But if you don't believe in ghosts, it's the wind and you go back to sleep. You give the ghosts power by believing in them. Your house is only haunted if you believe in ghosts. Belief is a powerful thing. If I were to stand in front of you and I were to tell you that I could punch you as hard as I can in your sternum, and I could fracture it and send a splinter into your heart, would you allow me to try? You wouldn't, because you know I believe I can.
Nah, that's actually funny as hell. Yo.
Actually wild.
Bro, okay.
There is a man on the planet, and that's why people are afraid of me. And you believe depression is a crippling disease, and that's why you're afraid of it.
But guys, just for context, Andrew Tate obviously knows depression is a real thing, man, and mental health is a real thing, but he has other stuff on that. But
Bro, stop being a little pussy, man. Nah, man. What is this PC book? Nah, man. Listen, if you're depressed...
It's not even PC, bro. Genuinely, I genuinely watched some of Tate's other stuff, and he believes in it, bro. He, like, tells guys how to get out of it, and he literally says, like, go, like, get your shit together, go get your six-pack, meaning, like, your physical health, and then say if you're depressed or not, right? This video just takes it way out of context. This is the reason why he was cancelled. That's the only point I'm trying to make.
What would you do if I wanted to start an OnlyFans?
I don't think there's anything intrinsically wrong with women doing OnlyFans, as long as I had influence and control over it.
What do you mean? Doing a bit of photographer and get the angles, yeah?
No. Not doing that's any real work, shit. But just, like, taking all the money.
Huh?
If my chick said, I want to do OnlyFans, I'm like, all right, then cool, go do it. How much you made? 10 grand, all right, give me 8. All right, cool.
Why would... What?
Okay. So, bruh. Umar, you're married.
Yeah.
Obviously, I know your wife would never do this, but let's say your wife one day came up to you and said, Umar, Habibi, I want to do OnlyFans. What do you say?
Absolutely not.
Let me rephrase the question, okay? Let's say you are dating someone who has an OnlyFans. How do you go about that?
Nah, time out. Oh, that's not a situation. I would not date someone who has OnlyFans.
Okay, good answer.
Give you 8 grand.
You're my woman, you're doing OnlyFans. You're selling my product. The fuck?
Your product.
Yes, correct. Next question.
No. Gee, I don't know if you're being serious.
I'm totally serious. How would I let my chick do OnlyFans and keep all the money? God. That's disrespectful.
What woman is ever going to give you that?
Then she better not do OnlyFans. Duh.
Okay. That right there, I remember watching this clip, and that right there resonated with me. The only part that resonated with you is this, right? If you asked me this question just now, Umar, what are you going to do if your wife comes up to you and says, I want to create OnlyFans? Bro, Tate's actually a genius. This is why I fuck with Tate. And I tell her now, yeah, you could only do it if I get 80%, you get 20%. Then she's going, why the fuck am I going to want to do it in the first place?
Bro, it's like an ultimatum, bro. It's like, you know when your parents are like, you ask them for something, you're like, okay, yeah, I'll do this, but then you don't get anything for your birthday, for Christmas, It's like literally like a similar thing, but obviously it's taken to the extremes.
Some child is outside enjoying their life, playing with toys and smiling in the sunshine and having fun. I hate happiness. I hate happy children. Anyway, you're all losers. We've discussed this before. I'm the king of the world.
Time out, bro. Is this what, like, the Hofstra University students watch?
Go to the club with your friends. I don't know what kind of bitch-ass dude is letting these chicks.
All right, time out. Riddies, I want to ask a question to you. I don't go to the club, so there's no question of my wife going to the club. If you had a girl, would you just let her go to the club with clubbing with the girls?
The only time this has ever happened, and the only reason why it happened, is because I was also doing the same thing at just a different place, literally right across the street. So afterwards, we both linked up anyways. If I had, like, an actual girl and, like, whatever, no, bro, my girl's not going to the club.
Dude, okay, here's the thing, bro. Like, I know there are definitely groups of girls that genuinely, they go to the club just to chill with the girls, right? And the guy will come to them and they'll reject them because, like, they want free drinks. They just want the affirmation that they're beautiful and men are approaching them. But, like, they go home, they're loyal, right? But, like, it's one of those things where, like, I don't want my girl to get tested. Like, why put your property at, like, I know someone might, I live in a nice neighborhood and I can leave my front door unlocked, right? I'm not going to.
No. You don't go to the club with your friends. I don't know what kind of bitch-ass dude is letting his chicks go to the club with her friends without him. No, you stay in the house. You don't go nowhere. You're not, no restaurants, no clubs, nothing.
Okay.
Restaurant, sure. I let my girl go to the restaurant, bro. If further girls want to go eat, bro, yo, I'll stay home. I'll play my video games. Bro,
I'd gladly have my girl go to the restaurant with her girls. Why? You know why? Bro, when girls go out, have you noticed? When a girl goes out with her girls to eat, they order two things.
That's true.
When they go out with you, they want the appetizers, the salad, the dessert, five different drinks. Because that's just how it works.
You're the virgin stroller.
What the fuck?
Why did you choose that insult? Why do you call people worms? And it's very, very clear to me, at least, why I call people worms. Worm is a pointless creature. The only reason a worm exists is so that bigger, more important animals can eat something. They don't do anything. They can't see.
They're peons.
They sit in the dirt and they just move around in the dirt and they try and hide a little bit and then a bird eats them. And most people live their lives as worms. Most of you are worms. You don't do anything important. You're just living in your shit life, living your little dirt, just sitting there wriggling, hoping an eagle doesn't come along to fuck you up. And if an eagle did come along, you couldn't even defend yourself. A worm has no claws. It can't, hasn't even got, like, a skunk can spray smelly piss or something. A worm has zero defensive mechanism.
Bro, I'm gonna start calling people a worm.
A worm is absolutely and utterly useless.
Dude, that last bit was like, come on, man. That was just stupid.
That pretty much wraps it up for this. If you guys want to see more Andrew Tate type videos, leave a like. Everyone comment, tournez dans la vie, everyone comment that. And we'll see you guys.